behind Pause to Read is that learning to read is really hard. And we can't test how well you read unless you can read out loud, which is even harder. But reading out loud in front of a person feels scary, especially if you're not good at it. So the idea is, if instead of reading out loud to a person, you can read out loud to a dog. And dogs are not judgmental, and they're super friendly, and they just smile and listen to you. And it helps to be able to just read out loud to a happy little creature.
For the family story time, we do have some rhymes and things that work through repetition, and especially for the little bitty kids, interacting with their parents, making friends, and even like the gross motor skills, like cutting things with scissors. And we have different types of scissors that kids can use that work like different parts of their hands. And that gives them just like a different experience.
And family story time, especially because it's Saturday mornings, it's a lot of kids that can't come during the week because their parents work or because they have dance class or whatever. Saturday mornings tend to be a little bit more accessible to families, and so the whole family can come and really just enjoy themselves at the library. That's our number one goal, is just to create happy memories at the library. And if we accidentally convince them that they like books, then we've done our job.
Coding club, we have one for tweens and one for teens, and it's sort of like we have these platforms that they start off on, and it takes them through just like basics. So like everybody starts off on the same level. So they watch a video, they go through all the different mazes, and then they learn the basics of a website. For the older kids, we just got a program called VidCode, and that is something that will allow you to create a portfolio of different projects. Like one of the things is like making filters, making memes from code.